I got involved with gangs at age 14 years old. And like most teenagers, I wanted to be a part of something. I didn't pretty much identify too much with my family, though I had a good family, both parents at home. I looked into the street for my role models. I admired the guy that I saw in the street. And to be a part of it felt like it was giving me a sense of identity. And the worst thing I saw was a 15-year-old kid shoot another kid that was 16 or 15 around his age, 3 times point-blank range in the face. And for that kid to fall to his knees and call for his mother. It hurt me dearly because we live in a community where we told the rules of the mind our business, but in reality, if that was my little brother, I would want somebody to help me. I would have to say spending most of my life in prison was the turning point. I'm tired of being sick and tired. I spent my 15th, my 16th, and my 17th birthday in prison. I came home and I spent my 19th, my 20th, and my 21st birthday in prison. Came home and I spent my 25th, my 26th, my 27th, my 28th, my 29th, my 30th, my 31st, my 32nd, my 33rd, my 34th, my 35th, my 36th, my 37th, my 38th, my 39th, and my 40th birthday in a cage. All because I bought into this mindset that when you go, you gotta go hard. And I was willing to die for my people. I was willing to throw away my future for that so-called cool embrace of my people. You know, when you hug your homeboys and, yo, I got you. I got you. It feels good. But let me be the first to tell you, it's bull. Because when you're doing all them years in prison, flipping the calendar all them months and all them days, you don't see none of them. You don't see a letter from them. And we put on this exterior like we're so big and bad, and that is not realistic for a human being. Just like the most toughest and the most dangerous gang members that spend most of their life in prison, they wouldn't tell you that they cry mostly every night when them lights go out and they have no future to come home to, and the rest of their days is going to be looking at this cage, these bars in front of them. They're not even mad enough to tell them I cry like a little baby. But that's the reality. That's realistic. And a lot of us that went the wrong way, that were affiliated and passes of violence, you become hood legends. Legends from the hood. And people tend to look up to that. And when you see young brothers from your community coming into prison, and they all happy to see you, and they're looking up to you for your respect, and you realize they're only here because they want to be like you. Then you realize something went wrong. Then all of a sudden you begin to care. And you realize this individual that's sitting in front of you can have a future. All you would have to do is tell them the truth, that it's not all what it's built up to be. That facade. You know? And I wish somebody would have told me the truth. I wouldn't have wasted so many years of my life. We have a core group of men who've came up through the Council for Unity program who actually mentor the youth inside prison, as well as mentor youth on the outside that come through schools. We're not anti-gang. We're anti-criminal activity. It's that negative thinking of the gangs that we're anti. Not the fact that they want to be a part of something, because a lot of people join gangs because of that need to belong. I would honestly tell someone who's watching that's thinking about joining a gang or already made the choice of joining a gang, I would tell you that you have the ability to be your best and you have the ability to be your worst. The one that wins is the one that you feed the most. There's nothing glamorizing about going to prison. There's nothing cool about being a part of something that people fear. It's not cool to be a part of something that hurts other people's lives.